Okay, so here we go. This section is called the seed, okay? And the Bible talks about the seed, you know, the a sower went forth to sow. It's Matthew 13. We're going to show that to you. I'm going to give you the scripture. But I showed you the breakdown of this entire hieroglyph, that there's an egg, that the kid's head is an egg. And the reason it is because it is the hatching of the new consciousness. Just like Lady Gaga said, she said, my performance is about the birth of the egg, and the rebirth is about a new race of beings being birthed within the human race. That's the abomination that causes desolation. Here he is. There's the abomination. And then he made it with humanity. And so you have an alien inside of a human. You have a kid that's got a head that's an egg. Then you have a dead sheep with its tongue sticking out. Here's the sheep's eye. Here's the red tongue sticking out of the mouth of the sheep right here that's open. Those are the nostrils of the sheep. And this yellow part is the ear of the sheep. You can see the tongue sticking out the side. So there's also a reptile in the fetal position. There's the head of the reptile, eye, nose. And so I decrypted this for you so you could see it. Now, the Bible talks about the seed. A sower went forth to sow. Now, remember the night I got saved? I took you down to the alley. The very first thing I walked into after I got saved, when Michael gave me my, I'll just call it my marching orders, I walked out of that alley, that one-way alley, and there was a wall, and it said, whatsoever man soweth, that must he also reap. Well, at the time I got saved, I received a supernatural set of spiritual gifts, and one was the gift of knowledge and discernment, the gift of wisdom. And you're looking at what that is, the ability for me to show you everything that's hidden in here. And I just showed it to you. There's an alien. Here's his neck. His neck turns into a penis. He's penetrating a female vagina. There's a woman on her knees. Her eyes here. Her head's here. Her hair comes down. This is her buttocks going down to her knee. Leg shoots out behind her body. Here's her other leg coming down and shooting back. So then alien is planting his seed within the woman. The seed of the serpent, the seed of the woman. What does the Bible say? I will put enmity between the seed of the serpent and the seed of the woman. That's Genesis 3. Okay, well, you're looking at it. I mean, the Lord is letting me show you that the Bible is absolutely true. But to me, it has been given to understand the mysteries of the kingdom of heaven. To them, it has not been given. It's Matthew 13. I'm going to show you the seed is the most important part of everything, because without having the right seed, you'll never understand the mysteries of the kingdom of heaven. Let me give you an example. We're going to go back this way now. And so y'all have already seen this hieroglyph. So now I'm going to go over here, and I'm going to stand over here, and I'm going to get out my Bible. I'm going to read to you. And we're gonna talk about the seed in Matthew 13. Now, don't forget, remember I showed you the pyramid from Guatemala? What's on it? Well, let's see. There's a devil superimposed over the face of a sheep. So there's the seed of the serpent over the seed of the woman, the sheep, seed of the woman. God calls us his sheep. John 10, my sheep hear my voice, and they follow me. Okay, so we have the seed of the serpent over there on top of the seed of the woman. We have the pyramid from Guatemala with the devil superimposed over the face of the sheep. It's a male penis and a female reproductive system. Do you think this is like some kind of weird accident that when you're dealing with the pyramids, you're always dealing with some other race of beings having intercourse with human women? I mean, well, I'll tell you what, if I can find it in the Bible, and I can show you in the Bible that that is the seed we're supposed to scatter. What do you mean by that, Jonathan? Well, what I mean is there's only one seed to get people to come to the kingdom of God. There's, you know, a lot of people convolute Christianity, and they like to have their denominations. Baptist, Methodist, Presbyterian, well, this one's right. We follow this set of rules. It's all wrong, all of it. There's only one Jesus. There's only one. And the identity of Jesus is everything. And if you don't know the Jesus, you don't know anything. The Jesus I know is the one that turned the world upside down. That's the one that I know. And I'm going to use the scriptures to prove all of this. And we're going to start with the seed. Okay, so I'm going to give you the seed to understand the kingdom of heaven. And I will show you that in this very chapter, if you read it, it will tell you that you will not understand this information if it has not been given to you from above. You don't get this unless God gives it to you. The only way you get it is you humble yourself and you say, help me, I'm lost, I don't understand. You know, I want to know who the real Jesus is. I just want to know the truth. Didn't the Bible say, and you will know the truth, and the truth will set you free? So, if we were bred with a fallen race of beings and we're hybrids, wouldn't that be the truth? Have I not said you are gods? But you shall die like men. Wow! There it is. They're the gods. They're fallen angels, hybrids, considered gods. But they bred with men, so we're their offspring. So you're gods that are going to die like men. Don't forget, I'm going to end up at CERN with all this. So don't lose interest. Don't go, oh, I've heard all this stuff. Wait till you see where this is going. This is going to the very end of it all, because the world's about to be turned upside down, the entire world. And I'll prove it using the scriptures. Okay, so let's get to the seed right now. I'm going to turn on an overhead light so I have a little more light. And so I can read very clearly to you. Okay, so Matthew 13 is the parable of the sower. And it says, and he spoke many things to them, and he spoke many things to them in parable, saying, behold, a sower went out to sow. And when he sowed, some seed fell by the wayside, and the birds came and devoured. And some fell in the stony places where they had no root of earth, and they immediately sprang up because they had no depth of earth. They died, you know. But when the sun was up, they were scorched because they had no root, and they withered away. And some fell among the thorns, and the thorns sprang up and choked them out. But others fell on good ground, okay? And so we're talking, and yielded a crop, okay? So only one of the groups of seeds, one of the groups brought forth a crop, okay? But what is the seed? I mean, what is that seed? Let's say if I go and I plant corn, what am I going to get? I'm going to get corn. If I go plant wheat, what am I going to get? I'm going to get wheat. So this is very cryptic, but I'm going to show you how easy it is to really understand it. Okay, so it's about sowing seeds, and it shows you where the seeds fell, and the soil that produced the good, you know, the good crop was good soil. So it's never the seed. It is always the soil that fails the seed. The seed never fails the soil, because the seed is always good. But it's the soil that fails. So now watch this. And the disciples said to him, why do you speak to them in parables? And Jesus said, listen very closely. Because it has been given to you to understand the mysteries of the kingdom of heaven, but to them it has not been given. So, to understand these mysteries, it has to be given to you. To them it's been hidden. Okay? For whoever has, to him more will be given, and he will have an abundance. But whoever does not have, even what he has will be taken away from him. Therefore, I speak to them in parables, because seeing, they don't see. And hearing, they do not hear, and they do not understand. And in them is the prophecy of Isaiah fulfilled, which says, hearing you will hear, and you shall not understand. Seeing you will see, and will not perceive. Let me give an example of that. Do you perceive this? Do you even get it? Here's a dead sheep. It's upside down. Okay, well, when Jesus told Peter what kind of death he was going to die to glorify God, he told Peter, feed my sheep. How did Peter die? Upside down. How did I reveal to you all the dead sheep? I turned everything upside down. That's the only way you can see the dead sheep. Do the math. The only way to see the dead sheep is to turn everything upside down. Or how would you ever know? Peter, your death is going to glorify God. Feed my sheep. That's very simple. Okay, so here we go. So in them is fulfilled the prophecy of Isaiah, that their eyes are closed, that, you know, and they cannot hear, and they are hard of hearing, their eyes have been closed, lest they should see with their eyes and with their heart, and hear with their ears, I'm sorry, and lest they should understand with their hearts and turn, so I should heal them. But blessed are your eyes, for your eyes see. Many prophets and kings have desired to see what you can see, but could not. Okay, so here we go. Then it says, therefore, hear the parable of the sower. And so it explains to you, it says, when anyone hears the word of the kingdom and does not understand it, then the wicked one comes and snatches away what was sown, snatches the seed. This is he who received the seed by the wayside. But when he received the seed on stony places, who hears the word and immediately receives it with joy, yet he has no root in himself, only for a little, and endures only for a little while. Because when you get saved, I'm telling you, when you see this kingdom of heaven thing, it is an endurance trip. You must endure it. Okay, so he can only endure for a short while. And then comes tribulation and persecution, and then they immediately falls away and stumbles at the word. Now he who received the seed among the thorns is he who hears the word, and the cares of this world and the deceitfulness of riches choke out the word, and he becomes unfruitful. But he who received the seed on the good ground is he who hears the word and understands it, and who is indeed bears fruit and produces some a hundredfold, some 60, and some 40. Okay, now here you go. I'm going to give you the seed right now. It's the same seed that was given to me. It's everything I've already shown you, but I'm going to use the scriptures to prove another race of beings bred with us. And you are this. You are a kingdom divided. You're half one thing and half something else. Good, bad. Right side up, upside down. All in the same body. That's your condition. Why do you think Jesus Christ was crucified on a cross? He reached out to one side and the other side. There's a guy on each side. And he is the bridge between the two going up to God, reconciling both to God through the cross, destroying the enmity. So that was a physical representation on planet Earth of God reconciling the two halves through his Son back to God. Now let me give you a quick example so you understand how perfect this is. Here is wisdom of God. The guy that was supposed to be on the cross, his name was Barabbas. Okay, well, back in those days, they had to have an executioner carve the crosses. You don't just go to Crosses R Us and pick them up and start crucifying people. You have to have a guy, carpenter, whatever, make the crosses for the guys that are in the prison on death row. So some guy makes some crosses. He goes, hey, we got Shimon, we got this other guy, we got Barabbas, so we need three crosses for this weekend. We're executing these three guys. So they make three crosses. Okay, well, there was a cross for a guy named Barabbas. Now don't forget, Jesus is here to take the fall for all of humanity. Jesus is the Son of the Father. Okay, so the Son of the Father is here on earth to take care of all our sin problem and reconcile both halves to God through the cross, destroying the enmity. That's Ephesians 2. Okay, here we go. Get ready. So, these three crosses are made. Pilate does not want to crucify Jesus because he's afraid. He's like, man, this guy's done nothing wrong. You know, I don't want to be part of this. So he offers the crowd, hey, look, I'll give you guys Barabbas or Jesus, because he's thinking, man, this is an opportunity to set this guy free. He's not guilty, and I can wash my hands of the whole deal. So he's trying to give Jesus back. And so he stands up there. He says, okay, you know, it's Passover, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to let you guys choose which one you want. And don't forget, everybody's a child of the devil until you're saved. So who do the children of the devil want? We want Barabbas. We want Barabbas. So he sets Barabbas free. The name Barabbas, bar means son of, like Simon bar Jonah, Peter, bar Jonah means son of Jonah. And the name bar Abba is son of the father. So you're telling me in the history of the whole world, three guys that were on death row during the time of the coming of the Son of God in a prison, three crosses were carved, and one guy's name was Bar Abba, which means son of the father, and that day some guy named Bar Abba got set free, and the real son of the father was on the cross? What? That's like, really? So Jesus, who is really the son of the father, takes the fall for Barabbas, the son of the father, and whenever you accept Christ, you're reconciled, you become Barabbas. Do you get it? That's how supernatural this is. You become Barabbas, son of the father. Now watch this. The letter A, B, and then put a slash, and B, A. It's a mirror reflection. Let's write it upside down. Or let's write it on A, B, line under it, B-A. It's a mirror reflection. Oh, wow. You mean like this? Oh, you mean like, oh, wow, right side up, upside down? It's the same right side up as it is upside down. It's an exact mirror reflection of itself. That's why when you know God, you cry, Abba, Father. Because you know what I know. If you don't know what I know, how do you know God? How do you? Because you've got religion? Okay, well, let me give you what the Word of God says. Here we go. Another parable he put forth, saying, the kingdom of heaven is likened unto. So the kingdom of heaven is likened unto. He's going to tell us what it's like, how to understand. Don't forget, he just said he's going to reveal, he's going to reveal the mysteries to you. It's been given to understand the mysteries of the kingdom of heaven. And so here it comes. He put forth to them, saying, the kingdom of heaven is like a man who sowed good seed in his field. I'll bet you $1 million none of y'all know what that word means, seed. Did you look it up, Todd? Do we got it?
Yes.
What does it mean, Todd?
It's from the root word sperma.
Yeah. That's kind of funny. I have a sculpture over here that has a female egg and sperma trying to fertilize it before I got saved. That's really weird, because over there is a hieroglyph that shows an alien injecting sperma into a human female. That's kind of weird, because I just showed y'all a postcard from Guatemala with the same exact thing. Female reproductive system, male reproductive system, devil superimposed over the sheep. Serpent superimposed over the sheep. Sheep upside down. You see what I'm saying? So let's keep going for a sec. So the kingdom of heaven is like an unto a man who sowed good sperma in his field, good seed. But while the men slept, his enemy came and sowed tares among the wheat. But when the grain, so the tares are the one, you'll find out who sowed the tares. But when the grain had sprouted and produced a crop, then the tares also appeared. So now you got two things growing together. Think of the Twin Towers, by the way. So the servants of the owner came and said to him, did you not sow good seed in your field? Then how does it have tares? And he said to him, an enemy has done this. Who's the enemy of God? Satan. So Satan has sowed the tares. So the servant said to him, do you want us to pull them up and gather them up? He said, no. Lest while you gather up the tares, you uproot the wheat with them. Let both grow together until the harvest. And at that time, harvest, I will say to the reapers, first gather together the tares and bind them in bundles and burn them. But gather the wheat into my barn. This is one of the only parables Jesus has ever explained. Go look through your Bible, try and find another one. So Jesus says, all these things Jesus spoke to the multitude in parables, and without a parable he did not speak. It might be fulfilled what was spoken of the prophet, saying, I will open my mouth in parables. Here you go, get ready. I will utter things kept secret from the foundation of the world. So Jesus is going to tell us secrets, something kept secret from the beginning of the world, from the foundation. And then Jesus sent away the multitudes and they all left the house. And then his disciples came to him. So this understanding wasn't for everyone. It was just for his disciples. And they said, would you explain to us, Jesus? Explain to us the parable of the tares of the field. And here we go. Here comes the seed. This is the seed that you should go out and plant with everybody. This is what you should go show everybody. This is the truth that sets you free. This is what needs to grow in your heart. It needs to grow in your mind. And when it happens, the whole world will change for you. And you'll see what I see. And you'll go, wow, I'm on an alien planet. I don't even belong here. That's funny. That's also what the Bible says. You're a sojourner. And he answered and said to them, he who sows the good seed, sperma, is the Son of Man. The field is the world, and the good seeds are the sons of the kingdom, but the tares are the sons of the wicked one. The enemy who sowed them is the devil. The harvest is the end of the age, and the reapers are the angels. Therefore, as the tares are gathered and burnt in the fire, so it will be at the end of this age. The Son of Man will send out his angels, and they will gather out of his kingdom all things that offend and that practice lawlessness, and will cast them into the furnace of fire. I'm pointing to my sculpture. I'm like, it's everywhere, guys. It's all over the artwork. Isn't that crazy? And they will cast them into the fire where they will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. Then the righteous will shine forth as the sun in the kingdom of the Father. He who has ears, let him hear. Whoa, we're talking about the wheat and the weeds. Guess what? Guess what wheat has? Ears. Wheat has ears. Now check this out, because we're going to get ready to go into the next section, which is the manifestation of the seed. We're going to show you how the seed is grown and how you know it's the harvest. So watch this. He whoever has ears, which means is wheat, because wheat has ears, let them hear. But if you're weeds, you're not going to hear any of this. You're not going to know what I'm talking about. You're going to leave hateful comments. You're going to write blasphemy and all this weird stuff because it wasn't given to you to understand this. And I'm sorry, but that's just the way it is. But if you humble yourself, even if you don't understand it, and you say, God, please, this is some scary stuff. I'm humbling myself before you. Please help me open my eyes, open my ears that I can understand. And I'm willing to give up all things that I might understand. That's what I would do. That's what I did. So now, here we go. I want to give you an idea, just a concept. So you have one that's right side up and the other one's upside down like this. Sorry, that finger's broken. That's why it's a little curved. So you have one seed that's right side up, okay, thumbs up. The other one's upside down. So you have different energy polarities, you know? Okay, so think about this. Jesus said, unless you're converted, you'll never see the kingdom of heaven. Converted from what? Well, let's look at the cross of Christ. You're two different things in one body. You must be converted through Christ. And when you get converted, guess what he does? He turns you upside down. Well, you know what happens? Your energy has to change. So you get a new spirit. That way you can get back to God. Because if you die in this condition, your energy cannot return to its source. Because energy can neither be created nor destroyed, but it can be converted in form. Isn't it funny? I have just enough physics to understand all this. I was wondering why I was in college. Why am I taking this stuff? I don't really like it, but it was for this time. So now it all makes sense. Did you know 2 Kings 21, I think, says, I will take Jerusalem, which represents all of us, the scattered children of the kingdom. I will take Jerusalem and wipe her and clean her as one wipes a plate and cleans it and turns it upside down. What do you do once you clean a plate, like back in the old days where they didn't have washing machines, they didn't have all these cool racks? What did you do with the plate? You would wipe it and set it upside down so the water would drain off of it. That's what I used to do with my plates. I set a towel on the tray and I'd wipe them and set them upside down. Read 2 Kings 21. I will take Jerusalem wiper and cleaner as one wipes a plate, so you get clean and turn it upside down. So scriptures, guys. So now we know that the seed itself is the story of the wheat and the weeds. Huh, that's funny. I just keep showing you the same thing. Aliens, fallen angels, demons, call what you want, having sex with human women, producing a hybrid race. Jesus said, any kingdom divided against itself. So I'm one thing. If I'm divided against myself, I'm brought to what? Desolation. The only way not to be divided against myself is to be reconciled through the cross of Christ and made whole. Ephesians 2. And I will destroy the enmity between the two, reconciling both to God in one body through the cross. Thereby destroying the enmity. Wow! Genesis 3. I will put enmity between the seed of the serpent and the seed of the woman. You get it? It is the seed. There is no other seed. And if you haven't been taught this, you've been lied to or you've been indoctrinated. Because my name, Jonathan Kleck, was not given to me on accident. I'm an end of the world harbinger, and I'm getting ready to show you that this field that's growing right now with all the people all over the planet, now the weeds have manifested to a point to where they're worshiping Satan openly because they know the pit is about to open up and that they're going to come out. Their rulers that created them or that hybridized them are going to come out and rule this planet. That's what the New World Order is. It's a new world order of Satan ruling Earth. You got it? Now, let me give you a concept. Satan and the fallen angels are imprisoned in the earth, right? Jude, they're kept under chains of everlasting darkness, awaiting the judgment of the great day. But guess what's going on the surface of the earth? There's a bunch of people walking around like an ant nest, but they serve the queen of heaven, Satan and the fallen angels. So they're walking around all over the planet. Everything they're producing, they produce, and it shows an outward manifestation of who their boss or who their master is. And I'm going to show this to you. It's all over the clothing. It's on your cars. It's everywhere you go. It's in the buildings. It's in logos of companies. It's everything. It's literally in the entire thing. So we're being controlled by them because we're all children of the devil until you get saved. And so everybody's up on the planet doing what Satan and his minions want us to do. We're building the world for them, and they're about to exit their prison because there's this big magnet called CERN, which is going to get turned on. By the way, it's in the shape of an octagon. Kind of weird. It's going to get turned on. It's going to change the polarity of the earth, and the whole earth is going to flip upside down like a big magnetic prison, and the door is going to open up. And then these things are going to come out like locusts, and it's going to blanket the sky and it's going to blot out the sun. And it's not going to be what people think. It's going to be all this stuff that the Lord had me do before I got saved. So I'd be able to believe it because this is so hardcore. I mean, without having my background, I'd be jumping off a cliff. If I couldn't look over my shoulder and see the predestination, this is too much for any human being to handle. And that's what my ministry is. God said, okay, you're the one. I gave it to you to understand the riddle of ages. You're the one I'm going to use to solve the riddle. And if you want to throw rocks at me, I could care less. My knowledge comes from the Lord God himself, right out of the Word of God. So we're going to put this stuff for you. Todd, is there anything that you can think of that maybe I haven't hit on that I need to touch on?
No, not that I could think of. It was quite comprehensive.
Was it? Did it come across okay?
I think so. I think it came across very well. I think the only thing maybe that I might mention is people get hung up on little things like you were talking about the clothing. The next video is going to be about the outward manifestation. But it's futile to think that you can control that or get all of that out of your house. You live
in It's like, he's wearing a Nike symbol. He's the devil! You know what? Go look in your closet. You'll have to get rid of pretty much everything. I'm not kidding. Even a button-down shirt. You know the shirts that have the collars? Well, when the collar's like this, it's got a button in the middle. It's a circle and a pyramid made by the collar. Ooh, throw it away. It's like, no, don't turn into a freak. because they make all the clothing. What about guess? Oh, it's a triangle with a question mark. Exactly. Get it? They're mocking you. Guess. Because you can't guess. But I can see behind the skin, folks. That's how I knew Alex, the kid, was going to draw a picture of me with a dead sheep on my head. How? Who in the hell knows that? Hey, that guy's going to draw a picture of me with a dead sheep. And I was right. It's like, ah! I mean, seriously, how crazy is that? To get it right. You should have seen Chris. He was like, oh my Lord, he drew a picture of Jonathan. You know what? Let's get over here. I'm going to show you another picture someone else drew. This is a guy named Marcel. This is a piece of wood. This is crazy. Marcel drew this on this piece of wood. And here it is. He drew a picture of me, a caricature of me. And I'm going to show you there's a knot in the wood right there. There's a dead sheep with its tongue sticking out. There's a goat right here with its eyes closed. And there's the horns of the goat, the ears of the goat. There's a dead sheep and there's a goat on my head. And there's a serpent eating me. I'll show it to you over here. I've got it in this book. So why in the hell are people coming up to me going, hey, I drew a picture of you. Like, what are you, freaking weird? I mean, are you stalking me or something? I drew a picture of you. It's like, that's kind of random. You just thought you'd draw a picture of me? I'm really... I mean, what the hell's that all about? You know, I thought, wow, that's really weird. Thank you very much for drawing the picture of me, I guess. It's like, okay, so let me show it to you. Here you go. How's that look, Todd? Does that look okay?
You may want to move it under the light.
There we go. Okay, so that's the same thing you just saw on the wall. And now what I'm going to do is I'm gonna take off the constituent parts and show them to you. Watch this. Let me turn this around. So here you go. Here you go. Here's a sheep. There's its eye. That was the knot in the wood. There's its nose. There's its tongue sticking out. Here's the ear. Everything's cleverly hidden. The goat's real easy to see. Here's the goat's closed eyes. They're black. There's a nose. It's got a pyramid on the nose. By the way, a pyramid in any equation, if you know physics or you know calculus or you know chemistry, that's a delta symbol, and delta means change in. And this is delta sheep. It turns into a goat. So here's the goat's horn, ear. There's the front hoof, and there's the hair going down. Okay, now down here is a Mayan Indian. There's the Indian's eye, his nose, his mouth, his chin. And he's wearing this hat, you know, like Mayan hat. But there's three pyramids behind it. Well, check this out. I want to show you something. You know what? Also, while we're on this page, I want to show everybody this real quick. This is that sheep I've shown you that's the virgin. You know, there's the eye of the sheep, the eye. There's the tongue sticking out, nostrils. But when you turn it the other way, it's a goat. There's the eye, eye. There's the nostrils. There's the teeth. And the ears coming down. So it's a goat one way, and it's a sheep the other way. Get it? Sheep and goats. Now let's look at the picture of Marcel did of me. Now I just drew in the sheep on my head. Look, there's the sheep on top of my head. He used a knot in the wood to make the eye with liquid coming out of the eye. There's a snoot of the sheep. Now look, there's a sleeping goat on the back of my head. My eyes are closed because that spirit is mocking me, saying you're blind. What did Jesus say? I've come to judge the world and to give sight to the blind, which was me before I got saved. And this was done before I got saved. I couldn't see any of it till after I got saved. Jesus said, and to show those that think they see that they are blind. And they said, are you saying we're blind? He said, if you were blind, you wouldn't be guilty. So your guilt is based on your ability to even see this stuff. So look at this. Here's a serpent. There's the two eyes of the serpent, and the serpent's mouth is wide open, and he's wrapped around my neck with the tail going around my neck. So the serpent's freaking eating me. What the hell? I'm like, what? That's on the hieroglyph over there. Well, this guy that did that gave it to me in 2001. It's even stamped on that thing. It says 2001. I couldn't see it. I was like, oh, wow, thanks, Marcel. That's kind of weird. Okay, cool. He just walked up to me and said, hola, Jonathan, yo lo hago para ti. He was Hispanic. He was from Guatemala. He made images of the Virgin all the time. And I went, oh, yeah, thank you. I'm just, yeah, random. You know how many times I've had people do this? It's like, I've had this happen many times. And that's why when someone comes and hands me a picture, I'm like, meh, because there's going to be a dead sheep on it. And it's somehow the devil recognizes me, you know, just like Paul. They said, you know, the demons, you know, that the guy tried to cast out of the people. I cast you out in the name of Jesus. the one Paul talks about, and the demon said, well, we know Jesus and we know Paul, but we don't know you. And they, you know, pounded the guy. That story of the Bible. So anyway, like I'm saying, there's only one seed. And it's in the Word of God. And it's sheep and goats, wheat and weeds. And if you don't have that, you're spreading the wrong thing. If you think Jesus is some kumbaya, feel good, get together and sing songs, that's not it. It's a war between darkness and light. And this is, we're showing you the light. Come out of the darkness into the light, folks. Now we're going to show you the outward manifestation of the seed that has taken over humanity. I'm going to get ready for the next section. I'm going to give you a quick statement. Todd said he liked this one, so I'll use it. So if you had a sheep and it was bred with something like a crocodile, that'd be a bit of, you know, a problem, right? So you'd have a crock of sheep, or whatever you want to call it. But what was normally an animal that just was very docile and, you know, calm and meek would turn into something that was part predator now. So there would be a conflict within that new species. You know, it would be conflicted. And eventually, the seed that was dominant would take over. How do you like your iPhone, by the way? Get it? It's being a smartass. How do you like your iPhone with the Apple with the taken out of it? The seed that's dominant, hint, 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 is going to eventually take over the other seed, tree of knowledge of good and evil. The tree of knowledge of good and evil. So I wonder where all this cool stuff comes from in the last like 50 years. Yeah. You see what I'm saying? So we've reached the tipping point, the eventuality, and now it's manifesting on everything. And so we're just going to do another section after this, the manifestation of the seed, so you know it's the harvest. Because at the harvest, the weeds, the tares are visible. Because if you know anything about the harvest, here's the way it works. Back in those days, there was weeds and there's tares and they were poisonous. But you couldn't go harvest the grain early. You know why? Because they look the same. So if you cut down the tares and the wheat and you mix it together, the tares could actually, you know, poison you. They were poisonous. So what they would do is they would wait till the harvest. And you know what happens at the harvest? The heads of wheat bow down, which is like us. We submit to God. We defer. You're right. I'm wrong. I defer. I'm going to live my life your way, not my way. The weeds stand straight up and are proud. Just like now, look at what's going on in the government. We have special rights, you know, because of your sexual agenda. I mean, that doesn't make any sense, right? I mean, we don't have to have heterosexual pride marches, do we? I mean, that's kind of weird, don't you think? Gay pride. Pride is number one enemy of God. So now that pride has blossomed. It's blossomed and they wear it on their shirts. And I don't mean just gay. I mean, because I have friends that are gay. I don't have anything against anyone that's gay. It's like that would like be saying I have something against someone that's a fornicator. Or I have something against someone that's, you know, covets something that they feel like they want real bad. It's like it's all just a sin. But it doesn't distinguish you shouldn't like them or care about them at all. That doesn't mean a thing. But you should hate the sin, not the sinner. You should love the sinner and hate the sin. You see what I mean? Because the sin is what's destroying them and what's turning them. So at the harvest, they would never cut down the wheat and the weeds ahead of time until you could see which was which. And I'm going to show you that now's the time. We can see what's what. It's manifested. So the harvest is coming right away. And CERN's getting ready to, whenever it happens, I don't know if it's going to happen this month, next month. I really don't give a rip. It's going to happen. And so they're going to use their little portal to open up the key to the bottomless pit. By the way, the key to the bottomless pit is a magnet. And it's going to turn the world upside down. Isaiah 24. And we'll get to that in the last section, CERN. Okay? That's it.